Hello, today we will talk about Samsung television comparing 2020 years. And let's talk about television screen resolution. 4K, all TVs has the same resolution. Smart TV SSC port has 7125 model, 8005 model, 8505 model. And there is no information about QLED 55 and Q60T model. Wi-Fi, all models and picture quality index PQE 2000s, 2100, and better quality 2000 and 800. Oh, sorry. And motion rate, the other settings, different settings. I can't say what is the number of this because it is has other setting and 100 motion rate. And let's talk about TV tuner. And very similar tuner. The price are more. Price model 8000 and 505 has digital DVB satellite second version too, and QLED has the analog and clear QAM and ATSC. And what about sound? All the same sound, 2.10 watts. Sorry, man, for two. And the power consumption and bigger screen, bigger consumption. But all these models has 55 screen inches, and the cheapest model 84 average watts, and maximum there is no, and 8005 model 102 watts. It is one of the highest number of these all four models. And the 8505 is the same as 7125 model. And sorry, man, for the and the lowest number and lowest consumption of electricity has QLED, and power consumption average 46 watts. And maximum 125 watts. And let's talk about power consumption of computer or TV displays. Very significantly can see based on the display technology used, manufacturer and build quality, the size of the screen, what is the screen showing, static versus moving images, brightness of the screen, and the power saving settings are activated. And what about screen resolution? Screen size 55 inches, all the same, and gigahertz, 50 and 60, all same, and HDR 10 and LG. And this model, QLED model, has Quantum HDR, more bigger, and better HDR. And however, this makes no difference to show smooth the image looks. There is no increase in detail of the movement. Your 120 hertz television. is just showing your some frames that you would see in 60 hertz television. Also, when you import 60 hertz video, some 120 hertz TV will just switch to 60 refresh rate. Sorry. And backlight, edge light. Directly the backlighting is local of 2D dimming and features that dims the backlight behind the rears of the screen and that display black necessary for LDC, the TV featuring high dynamic range HDR. 2D dimming allows the greater contrast, so the blacks appear darker and deeper when film or video is vivid. HDR is not possible with edge LED. And direct LED backlighting can help lower panel manufacturing cost. Main difference between Dolby Digital and HDR Plus then is the color depth of brightness and content is equipped is capable achievementing. Dolby Digital contrast is mastered in the up to 12-bit color depth compared to HDR 10-bit, which is 10 HDR gets its name for ROM. And the information can be little too old like this because. In what about processor? 4 cores, all same. DLNL. Yes. Optional system. Tizen 15.4.5. Bluetooth version 4.2, all same. And the bigger version, more matters, more frequencies. What about USB? Lower model, lower. And less USB, one USB 7125 model and all other models with two USB ports, HDMI two ports, cheaper model and pricer models has three ports, satellite in all models has it. HDR, HDMI dynamic range, essentially it promises a wide range of brightnesses, color and contrast, because your eyes can perceive more information that TVs has traditionally been able to display. And what about remotes? Cheaper remote is garbage remote. Sorry. Not so good remote, I guess this there is no information how looks these models, but I think look it can look like this because these models are better class, but before buying please check this remotes. And the real remote and QLED silver and smart remote, so and the normal remote full HD and 4K most 32 inches TV full HD which gave a resolution of 120x10 and 9 pixels for gradually being overtaken by ultra common which gives a resolution to 38 and 40, 20, 60. That's 4 times the number of pixels crammed into a general and same TV sizes. It means greater sharpness, detail and clarity. There is used to be a real lack of 4K content, but these days there is plenty of stream of Netflix, Amazon video and you can buy in 4K Blu-rays. And what about distance to size TV? Lower resolution video, longer distance. And you can see screen size, recommended usage distance 30 and recommended cinema distance. And what about 55 and 2.2 meters? Better quality videos you can watch from 1 meter and 70 centimeters. And what about this? You can see full HD, you can see 2 meters and 14 centimeters and 4K, better quality, better lower distance. But there is not so big content of 4K for choosing it, and so you have to watch most of all 1080p or less quality videos, because that you have to sit longer in longer distance. LCD LED or QLED. LCD is the most common through the big difference between the cheapest and most expensive LCD TV due to the types of backlight panel and the processing technologies used. OLED is relatively new technology and expensive, but it seems seen as natural just for to plasma technology. Unlike LCD and OLED, the pixel produce their own light, so they no need for backlighting and edge lighting. Contrast and rich colors are in its strengths. All few LCD screens are generally brighter. QLED is a tricky one. It lasts a few years. QLED has been used for a few years to heroical self-lighting technology similar to OLED. But now Samsung is using QLED name refer to the latest Quantum Dot TV. This is still LCD technology. One of the fancy crystals considers a beefier version of LCD rather than entire new category. What about 3D and Curve TV? Is old technology, sorry for that. There is a commentation speculate similar death of Curve TVs. However, Samsung continue to push format. The major drawback is a sweet spot for watching TV and little smaller. So if you have multiple viewers at different angles, they may not always get the best picture. The best picture will be if you sit in the middle of the screen. Ultimate Curve TV largely come down to personal taste as a static choice. They don't allow rather special all through. They always change. They go over the fashion further down the line. How much I should pay? Many smaller TVs are considering not worth the price tag. If your small screen is what you want, it's probably not working playing in the 2500 or 560 for anything less than 43 screen. For the best results in 4K, you will need a screen size around 50 inches, better less, unless you want to sit very close to the screen. For just under 100, you can get a quality mid-range 50-inch model with HDR. There is a high upper limit. Lack of one 4K TV may cost a region in the 1,500. And for the highest quality with QLED OLED display is impressive screen size. What are the features, things to consider? Screen size. 4K looks better on larger screen. And do you necessarily need a 75-inch TV that dominates in a room to get the best results? Sound. The TVs come with built-in sound and watch provide a decent quality sound in the room, but you may not want to invest a speaker system for better results. Connectivity. Check the number of HDMI and USB ports in model. For HDMI ports may be necessary if you have several gaming devices. Brightness. If you plan to watch TV in a dark room and TV with a LED screen will give a greater contrast and better blacks, darker color, lighter room and different will be less pronounced. QLED TV is also good TV. Operating system smart TV with their own operating system such as Android TV, WebOS is this, and most of these are compatible with apps such as Netflix and BBC player, but always worth checking first. Some are considering more advanced and friendly, user-friendly HDMI compatibility. Given this is such a new technology, many video apps or services don't even support contact accept certain stave, but better it will be this compatibility good for to have. Don't forget to subscribe my videos, please reply to this video and comment, please check my other videos. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.